Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to A Flair for the Gold with your host, Nature Boy Ric Flair. Also featuring Fifi the Maid. Tonight's special guest will be the WCW World Tag Team Champions, Stunning Steve Austin and Flying Brian Pillman, the Hollywood Blondes. And now, Nature Boy Ric Flair.
After that party last week, we got to bring things back down to earth. Yeah, here we are. It's A Flair for the Gold. We're live again. It's Penthouse Paradise. And as promised, another really big show. We got the World Tag Team Champions here. We got Double A over here. We got Fifi. We're 1 week out from Slammarie Legend Reunion. And Double A, I know, one week from now, you got Barry Windham for the World Heavyweight Championship. You ready, Double A?
You know I am, champ.
Brother, I know you're ready. Are we ready for the World Champions? Oh, wait just a minute. All you guys out there, take that deep breath, because I'm gonna let Fifi walk that aisle for all of you. Fifi, bring it down that aisle one more time. This is why we are Flair for the Gold. This is why we're on the way live and getting back to next week, Slammarie 93. Missy, baby!
No, Missy, thank you, baby! Stop it! Stop it! I had to come all the way here. I got a run in my house and I broke it.
No!
You left
me.
No, you left me on the side of the road. And you
I didn't know she got all the cars, you?
Hey, Missy, we're aware of your many talents, honey. And you're a pretty good reporter, too. Just relax.
Reporter, too? Yeah. Let me tell you something, Double A. Not in this lifetime, not even on your best day, could you be a 60-minute man?
Ooh, I'm not touching that double. I think the balls in your coffee, man. Honey, you gotta get a grip. Calm down, everything's great.
Tell your little servant lady that if she wants to look good in that outfit, I think she needs to see a doctor. And let me tell you something, guys. You haven't seen the last of me.
Whoa!
Jeez!
Well, I told you we were gonna slow the show down a little bit, but as usual, we're cooking. You okay, Double A?
You said bottoms up. I guess she took it literally.
Well, I guess she did. You okay,
Fifi? Yeah, I guess so.
All right. Well, as promised, the World Tag Team Champions, Flying Brian and Stunning Steve Austin, the Hollywood Blondes. Here they are. Woo! All right, Flying Brian. All right, brother. Good to see you.
How you doing, Rick?
You got a pretty good grip for a young fella. How you guys doing?
Good.
Hey, I can't tell you, we're thrilled to death to have you on the show. You know, Brian, I've known you 5-6 years now, brother. You're finally at the top of your game. Steve, just caught your act in the last couple months, but Double A tells me you could be the man someday, brother. You guys got the straps now. You're the champs.
Yeah.
You're on top. What do you think, huh?
It feels good to be on top, Rick, but before we get started, I just want to say that Brian and myself have been on sets everywhere. And this is top notch. This is the best I've seen. You've done well for yourself, old man.
There's no stuff in here. Like, I feel like I'm in a museum.
You got some great antiques here, Rick. How much you pay for that old statue over there?
Steve, that's Double A. Anyway, Rick, you've had a fabulous career. What was it? 6-7-time world champion.
Nine times.
Could you do me a favor?
Yeah.
Could I get your autograph? Mind you, it's not for me. My great-grandmother is a big fan of yours.
Oh, gee, Brian. You know, well, for the sake of your great-grandmother and for the sake of people that grow old, you know, we all grow old, but very few of us get great, Brian.
Hey, speaking of great, I was in the history books just the other day, and I was looking back way, way back when you, Rick, and Double A were part of a elite organization. Was the Four Clovers, the Four Hunchbacks?
No. The Four Horsemen.
Oh, you mean that famous backfield from Notre Dame?
Well, similar. We did about the same thing for wrestling they did for Notre Dame. You know, we blazed our own path right across the country. We dominated.
Well, you dominated, Rick. But that was yesteryear. That's all in the past. If the Four Horsemen were around today, they wouldn't stand a chance, because the Hollywood Blondes are the team of the 90s. You're looking at it right here.
Well, listen, you know what? I didn't bring you out here to run you down or anything else. I want to talk about, and I'm sure the folks out here want to talk about, Slamboree 93. You got Shane Douglas, you got Ricky Steamboat, you got the steel cage looking at you guys. You ready for the match?
Look, Rick, we've already given Steamboat and Douglas a brush with greatness. Let's not lose sight of the fact of the real reason we're all at Slamboree. Thanks to the generosity of Steve and myself, we're flying in all those has-been, washed-up old-timers, these so-called legends who are falling on hard times, and we're going to bring a nice, hot, home-cooked meal to them. And I got to believe your right-hand man, old Double A, might be first in line at that buffet because it's obvious he hasn't missed too many meals lately.
No, wait.
Double A. Hey, brother, we won't let this slide tonight. We got a hot show going here. You guys, you know what? You got to remember one thing. You're the guest on my show.
We're the stars, player.
You're out of line, and you're out of your league on this field, pal.
No, this isn't worth this, Double A. Like I said, you guys are the guests on my show. We're not going to take this. You sit down, we'll forget the whole thing ever happened. Let's keep talking here now.
No. I got to say, Arn, who are we kidding? You guys are going to be there, too. You get together with the rest of the old codgers, maybe after the meal, play some checkers, chew some raisins, maybe soak the dentures. You guys can have a small time.
Is that right, huh?
Yeah.
You guys are coming across pretty good right now. Maybe we should talk about this a little more seriously.
Well, maybe I was getting ready to ask you a question, Rick. Maybe before you blow that pacemaker, you tell Brian and myself, are you ever going to break out those mothballed old trunks of yours with the wool on them and get that robe that's made out of pterodactyl feathers and get back in the ring? Can you cut the mustard?
Oh, is that right? Well, maybe I can break that stuff out right now, and I can show you how to cut the mustard.
Off. Get him a Geritol of ours.
A Geritol of us? You guys are stars on my show. This is my show.
Calm him down,
I'm trying to keep myself together, man.